Hello and welcome back to another Python Beginners Challenge. To complete this challenge, we need to write a program that accepts letters and numbers and returns the quantity of numbers and letters inputted. So we should be utilizing the terminal here to ask the user to write or input something, and that can be a mixture of letters and digits. So the idea here is that our program will then take that input and then count how many letters that have been inputted, how many digits, how many numbers have been inputted. We can then extend the program to then also count and return the amount of upper and lowercase characters inputted. Okay, so let's give this a go. Right, let's get rid of the old tutorial there. Right, so let's go for an input. So let's say, let's call this words equals, it's not really words, is it? Input, let's not just call it x. X equals input. There we go. So that's the user's input. So that should return that. There we go. Right. So what we need to do here then is we need to be able to calculate the digits and letters that have been inputted. So we're going to need to store them somewhere. So let's create a dictionary for this, and then we'll go ahead and we'll update that dictionary. So counted, we call this counted equals, and then we'll create a dictionary here. So we'll create two keys. We'll call this digits, or let's call this numbers. So we've got our key here, and then we're going to need some sort of value. So let's start off with zero, and then we'll do the same thing again. So the key here is going to be letters, and then we'll set that to zero. Okay, so now we have an empty dictionary here. We need to take the input, the user's input. We need to then count the amount of numbers or digits that are inside of that input and how many letters. So let's not forget that when we input here, we will then return a piece of data that we can iterate over. So if the user enters something like this, we can iterate over each character in that input, and then we can go ahead and count. So it looks like we're going to need to utilize here some sort of loop. So we need to iterate over the input step by step and then count as we go along. Let's go ahead and utilize a for loop to iterate over the input. And then we'll say for item or I, let's go for I in X. And so basically we're taking the input here. Let's just call this user input. Why not? So we'll grab the user input and then we're going to iterate over it one by one. So we're going to take every individual character, letter, number, and then we're going to pass it into I and then iterate over that. So the purpose of this challenge was to introduce some of the different built-in functions. And the first one is digit. Okay, so this is going to return true or false, and it's going to check whether the digit that we're trying to, that we're passing in. So remember the user's input. So if we inputted vary, then V would go across to I, and then we would check to see if it's a digit or not. So if it is a digit, if V was a digit, then we would return true, in which case we need to then update the amount of numbers that we found. So isDigit is a built-in function that's going to check whether the item that you present to it is a number or not. So that's what we're going to do here. That's what we're going to use. So looks like we're potentially going to need an if statement. So let's say if I, that's the character that's being passed in here, let's do letters first. So we have isDigit, but also you can see here from this list, we also have isDecimal, isASCII. So we've got a few different tools here. So let's do alpha first. So that's going to check whether it's a letter or not. Let's utilize this first. So this is a function. So that's going to check and return true or false. Remember here we're using an if statement. So this here is then returning true or false. So if this is true, so if we have found a character here in the input, then we are going to need to update our dictionary here. So we can do that very easily. So let's just grab it. We'll say counted. That's the name of our dictionary. And we're going to grab the key, which is letters. And then we want to do something with the data. So we can do that. We're going to need to put that in the doubles there. So we then need to increment. So let's say plus equals 1. So that's going to then update this value here to 1. So let's just see this. Let's see this in action. So we'll go ahead and just we'll print the counted. Apologies, let's bring this down so you can see everything. Okay, so we're going to print counted once we've inputted. So let's just run this. That is the wrong application, so I'll just close that. So it's example 2 or 1. Example 1. So let's just type in the letter A, and you can see what's happened here is we've returned 1, or we've updated the dictionary here, letters to 1. So let's just try that again. I'll type in AAA. So we should return letters 3. And there we go. So we can now do the same thing. So we can just create an else if, or we could run an if statement. So let's say else if. Check the programming language. And now let's say if I dot, let's say is digit. So we have it is digit. Then basically we're going to do the same thing again, counted plus 1. But obviously this time it's not letters, it's going to be numbers. Okay, and there we have it. So that should cover the first part of this challenge here. We'll just finish this off by extending the program to also now count the quantity of upper and lowercase characters. So let's just extend this slightly. Let's first update the dictionary. So we include now the upper and lower key value. And now we can just go ahead and extend our else if. So this time we want to check or detect is upper and is lower for uppercase and lowercase. So else if I dot, let's go for is upper. See, it appears right here. So is upper. So this is going to detect whether an uppercase exists in the input. So this is going to be upper. And then we can do the final one then for I is lower. Right, so let's go ahead and test this out. So we can see from the output, this isn't working properly. So what exactly is going on here? And this is maybe a common theme that I see beginners fall into. Here we have an if-else if. So ultimately, this if statement, we're trying to match one of these items. So for example, here the input character is either going to be a number or a letter. So if it is a number, then it's going to fall into this else if here, and it's going to be counted. And at this point, we need to ask ourselves, well, what happens? Does the program continue to look? And the answer to that, based upon the evidence we got here, is no, it doesn't. So it looks like it then falls out of this if statement and then continues. So once this has been met, is alpha is digit, then the if statement is then broken. So therefore, we don't actually get to these components here. So the likelihood is that we're going to need to create a new if statement block because the character is upper or is lower. It's a choice. So we need to break that up. So let's go ahead now and run this once more. And you can now see that the characters' letters have been counted correctly. So these tools like is alpha, is digit, is upper, is lower, they can be very useful in certain situations, particularly when we're working with data or sorting, or we're trying to clean data. So understanding how they work is important, so it'd be well worth reading through this. So for example, you may have considered, or you may have thought that potentially this would be counting some of these special characters as, for example, is alpha. So in actual fact, if we do that, you can see it doesn't count these special and punctuation characters. So now it's over to you, some homework. Take a look at this code. What I'd like you to try and do is refactor this code in a way that retains its readability, but reduces the amount of code that we use to produce the outcome that you've seen. Now that's the challenge. Please leave your answers in the video comments. It'd be great to have a look at them and sharing that with the community. And there we have another Python Beginners challenge called Counting Inputs. So these challenges will get much harder. I am just trying to cover as many basic challenges, or I say basic, but beginner challenges as possible, just to build this up, and then we'll start to feed into more complex challenges over time. Hopefully you're enjoying the challenges. If not, then I do apologize. Let me know what I can do to improve on them. If there's any particular formats or anything that I'm missing that you think would improve the challenges, maybe more examples need to be provided, or maybe I need to provide more detail, just let me know. It's always good to get feedback. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you in the next challenge.